Hare Krishna. The cure for lust comes not by condemning the object, but by cleansing the subject. The object of lust refers to the thing that triggers lust within a person. And the subject of lust refers to the person within whom lust is triggered. So for example, a person may see some hoarding which is sexually explicit, and then that sight may trigger lust. So the hoarding is the subject, is the object of lust, and the person is the subject of lust. So now the condemning the object refers to passing the blame for one's improper behavior to the external object. Sexual offenders, people who commit offenses and victimize others because of their sexual desires, they often blame the victims and they condemn the objects. They say that, no, those who dress like that, they are asking for it. Now, this sort of blaming the victim is distasteful, and it is also logically and philosophically wrong. The Bhagavad Gita has little patience for such self-serving rationalization of irresponsibility and immorality. In the Bhagavad Gita 3.36 to 3.43, it's a very insightful analysis of lust, how it attacks and how it can be countered. So therein, in that analysis, in 3.40, the Bhagavad Gita zeroes in on the locations, the strongholds of lust. If we want to counter enemy, we need to know where that enemy is situated. And the Bhagavad Gita declares that it is situated in the senses, the intelligence, the mind and the intelligence. Indriyanam hi charatam yanmano anuvidhiyate tadasya harati pragyam vayurnavamivambhasi. So indriyanam hi charatam, indriyanam, senses, charatam, senses are wandering about, sorry, not indriyanam hi charatam, indriyani mano buddhir asyadhishthanam ucchate etair vimohayatesha jnanamavritya dehinam. So indriyani mano buddhir asya adhishtanam, is located, sitting, residing places, the bastions of lust are these three. So it's significant that the Bhagavad Gita says lust is present in the senses, the mind and the intelligence. It is not in the objects. So it is not in the, lust is not present in the people who dress in provocative ways. It is present in those who get agitated by that lust. So that's why one cannot blame others for one's improper actions. Lust is within us, and when we let that lust get triggered, we act improperly. So we have to take a personal responsibility for that. Now at the same time, we have to understand that the object of lust is also a subject in many situations. That means, now of course a hoarding is not a subject, it's just an object, it's unconscious. But when people dress in provocative ways, then that may trigger lust in others. But there is lust in those people also. When people dress in revealing clothes, that they are also subjects, and they also have lust in their senses, mind and intelligence. And it is that lust often which impels them to dress in skimpy clothes and thereby get some titillation by attracting the carnal attention of others. To have everyone becoming attracted to one because of one's alluring form. There is some gratification in that, and that gratification is largely due to lust. So one has to be careful that one doesn't pander to that. Now of course, the way one dresses cannot and should not be held responsible for the actions of others if others perpetrate some sexual offenses. Those perpetrators are responsible for that. But it's also true that for on the part of the object come subject, you know, the giving in to the impulse to desire in scanty clothes, that itself comprises a caving in to lust, and that is unhealthy for that person. So if we want to cure lust, we have to go beyond the blame game and the victim game. We have to recognize that all of us, subjects and objects, are ultimately targets of lust. And we each need to take up individual responsibility to do whatever is necessary for countering lust, for protecting ourselves from lust. And the best protection strategy is the practice of Bhakti Yoga. By cultivating remembrance of Krishna, we experience a higher spiritual happiness and we become purified, and thereby we become free from lust's captivating allure. Thank you. Hare Krishna.